Hello friends, welcome to Akul Mac Live. I am Kanchan Verma. Today we will be discussing about Raag Yaman. But before that, I would like to remind you that there is a free gift available only for you. Stick around to this wonderful show till the end. We will guide you how to avail your free gift. Hello friends, welcome to our show. And today, as you know, is Wednesday and we have Akul Mac Nightingale with us. So without wasting any time, I would like to welcome Dr. Shambhavi Das. Welcome to the show, Shambhavi. How are you doing today?
Namaste everyone and good morning. Again, very special thanks to Kanchanji. I'm doing very good today. And thanks for inviting me again.
It is all our pleasure, Shambhavi. And before I start talking to you, I would like to hear your beautiful voice and a beautiful song from you.
So, thank you so much for the compliment, and I would like to sing a song. It is not a bhajan for a change, so it will be a song in Raag Yaman, which I'll be discussing today. And so I will just start with Raag Yaman, and it's a very, very, I think it's the most popular raga so far, and you will find 90-95% of the songs in this raag. So I think it will be a great episode today because everybody might be knowing this raag through the songs. Nire gare nire sa ni dha ni re sa
Today we are discussing Raag Yaman. So tell us about this raag and how it affects people, and is it easy to learn this raag?
So yes, this is actually one of my favorite raag, and this is, I think, many people's favorite. Sometimes even non-musicians sing them, not knowing that this is Raag Yaman. This is so popular. And this is why this is popular, because it has all the notes shuddha. So it goes like a normal melody. And a very, very good characteristics in this raag is that like in ragas, in classical music, there's a lot of rules and regulations and grammar of the rag, which is called chalan. But in this rag, even if you twist, turn and twist it according to anything, it remains yaman only. Nobody will question you that, no, why did you put this, unless you have just totally, you know, changed the raga. So it starts from sa ni re ga. So instead of sa, it starts from the ni. Sa ni re ga ma dha ni sa. So ma is normally upper side ma. It's not a shuddha ma. It is the tivra ma in it. That is the higher, the ma which is from higher frequencies. Ni re ga ma dha ni sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. So if you see, ni re ga is the chalan. Ni re ga. So many songs you will get to see. आंसू भरी है निरगा, निगाहें मिलाने निरगा, ये मोह मोह निरगा गा गा गा. Then हुजूर इस कदर निरगा, जब दीप जले निरे पा, जब दीप जले आना निरे पा, अरे सा निरे, अगेन निरे निरे निरे, फुल यमन, निरे पा परे सा नि सा, जब शाम ढले आना. सो दिस वे यू कैन फाइंड अ लॉट ऑफ सॉन्ग्स निरेगा निरेगा, एंड all the notes are shuddh in it, especially even in the recent times also you will find the Bollywood songs and old Hindi movies are totally filled up with it. So it goes up with nere ga ma dha ni sa, all notes shuddh with tivrama, comes back with all notes shuddh tivrama, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Like I sang the song tere bin सानी पा, सेम सॉन्ग साथिया. सो दिस इज द सेम ट्यून. सो इवन विद द ट्यून्स पीपल अंडरस्टैंड दैट ओके दिस इज, दिस सॉन्ग इज सिमिलर टू दिस सॉन्ग, मे बी दिस इज यमन सो दैट शुड बी यमन. दिस इज हाउ पीपल गेट इट. सो इट्स वेरी इजी राग एंड इट्स वेरी इजी फॉर द पीपल टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड सिंग.
होता यूँ है कि जनरली लोग ये बोलते हैं कि भाई जो इंडियन म्यूजिक है वो तो इतना अच्छा होता है और से हमारे जो सर है वो हिलता है, हम म्यूजिक सुनते हैं बहुत अच्छा लगता है. और वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक में ऐसा होता है कि हमको डांस करने का मन करता है. तो वंस फॉर ऑल आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू कि व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक एंड इंडियन म्यूजिक.
वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक इंडियन म्यूजिक में तो बहुत डिफरेंस है. सबसे ज़्यादा बड़ा डिफरेंस है, जैसे मोदी ने कहा था एक बार, हमारे जो प्रधानमंत्री हैं उन्होंने कहा था कि भारतीय संगीत में, भारतीय संगीत मन को डुलाता है और जो हमारा पाश्चात्य संगीत है वो तन को डुलाता है. तो तन को, आई थिंक ऐसा नहीं है, जैसे कई बार म्यूजिक के फास्टनेस पे भी डिपेंड करता है. अब आप बॉलीवुड सॉन्ग्स ले लें और आप वो वाला गाना सुने कि फिटनेस से रिलेटेड है, कि माँ की चोट से दंगल तक है ना 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 प्यारे दंगल दंगल, इसमें किसी का भी सर हिलेगा और पैर थिरकेंगे. या वो गाना है घर मोरे परदेसिया, ये इतना फास्ट है. तो आई थिंक वो बीट्स पे डिपेंड करता है. तो ये बात तो अलग है कि बहुत से जैसे गाने डांस करने का मन उस पे करता है, बट मुझे लगता है उनका ये मानना था कि जो हमारा इंडियन म्यूजिक होता है वो आपके दिल को छूता है, क्योंकि और डिपेंड करता है आपने उसको बचपन से सुन रखा है. हमारा जो म्यूजिक है वो एक सबसे बड़ा जो डिफरेंस है वो हमारा म्यूजिक एक पिच पे रहता है. कि जैसे मुझे तानपुरा बजाना ही पड़ा, क्योंकि मेरा एक पिच पे रहता है. कोई भी गाना हम गाएंगे तो वो एक स्केल पर रहेगा. जैसे कहते हैं ना, हमारी एक फाउंडेशन हमें बनानी पड़ेगी, एक प्लेटफॉर्म बनाना पड़ेगा. वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक में हार्मनी है कि आप एक पिच से दूसरे पिच पर आप जंप मार सकते हैं. हाँ, वो दोनों पिचेस सिंक्रोनाइज्ड होनी चाहिए, कॉन्सोनेंस में होनी चाहिए, वो बात अलग है. लेकिन हम ऐसे नहीं कर सकते हैं कि हम एक ही गाने को दो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पिचेस को हार्मोनाइज करें. तो वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक इज बेस्ड ऑन हार्मनी, इंडियन म्यूजिक इज बेस्ड ऑन मेलोडी. मेलोडी मतलब कि मोडल म्यूजिक, हमें एक मोड को पकड़ के रखना पड़ता है. तो इसलिए क्या है कि हमें एक छत मिलती है, इट्स लाइक अ होम कॉन्सेप्ट, कि जैसे एक बिलोंगिंगनेस है कि हमने एक मोनोफोनिक ट्यून को पकड़ रखा है तो हमारा एक एक स्टैग्नेंसी बन रही है, एक शांत रस बन रहा है. कोई चीज हमें ऊपर से कनेक्ट करी. अभी आप तानपुरा बहुत देर तक सुनते रहेंगे आपका मन शांत होगा क्योंकि आप एक ही मोनोफोनिक ट्यून पे बहुत टाइम से हैं. तो हमारा म्यूजिक, मुझे ऐसा लगता है, इंडियन म्यूजिक स्पिरिचुअल ज्यादा है, इसलिए वो मन को डुलाता है. मतलब ये इंटरप्रिटेशन है. वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक में आप एक सुर पे नहीं रहते हो, आप अलग अलग सुर पे भागते हो. तो उनका म्यूजिक आई थिंक स्टिमुलेशन के लिए बेटर है कि आपको एकदम से अपने आप को स्टिमुलेट करना है. तो वो रिलैक्सेशन और स्टिमुलेशन का सबसे बड़ा डिफरेंस है. और रही बात डांस करने की, तो बॉलीवुड में और इवन क्लासिकल में हमारे में बहुत सारे ऐसे गाने हैं, ऐसा क्लासिकल म्यूजिक है, तबला म्यूजिक है, जिसमें आपको डांस करने का मन करेगा. लेकिन हाँ, बच्चों का रुझान या लोगों का रुझान उस तरफ ज़्यादा है, और उस पर भी डिपेंड करता है कि हम बचपन से क्या सुन रहे हैं. तो उस पर भी डिपेंड करता है कि हमें उस तरफ ज़्यादा रुझान है और क्लासिकल म्यूजिक में कम है. कि आप अपने बच्चे को कोई चीज बचपन से सिखा रहे हैं तो वो ठीक, वो फिर उसी हिसाब से बच्चा सुनता है.
खैर, ये तो बात हुई गाने की, बट कुछ ऐसे इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स भी होते हैं जो कईयों को अच्छे लगते हैं. जो यंग जनरेशन है वो गिटार सीखना चाहती है. आपका फेवरेट इंस्ट्रूमेंट कौन सा है?
मेरा फेवरेट इंस्ट्रूमेंट सितार है. मैंने कुछ टाइम सितार सीखा भी हुआ है, और लेकिन सुनने में मुझे फ्लूट भी बहुत पसंद आता है, क्योंकि आप फ्लूट सुनेंगे आपका बिल्कुल एक रिलैक्सेशन और डी स्ट्रेस करेगा. तो मैं इवन स्ट्रेस पेशेंट्स को भी फ्लूट ज़्यादा रिकमेंड करती हूँ. बच्चों में मुझे लगता है हाँ, गिटार अच्छी चीज़ है और मुझे भी बहुत पसंद है.
तो जब हम बात करते हैं कुछ वेस्टर्न इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स की, जैसे कि सेलो है या गिटार है, सो कैन वी रियली प्ले इंडियन रागास ऑन दीज इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एंड दे व्हाट यू फील दे शुड दे विल बी कमिंग आउट इन अ क्वाइट ए क्लासिकल वे व्हेन वी आर प्लेइंग गिटार और सम वेस्टर्न इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एंड मे बी आस्किंग आवर चिल्ड्रन टू लर्न रागास ऑन मॉडर्न इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स.
So yes, you can easily play the ragas and in the like all the western instruments, but the question is good ki wo jo ek nuances hain, the like the way we handle the ragas and the way we have a technicalities in the Indian classical music, they may not come into the western music. But yes, but I may be wrong in that, क्योंकि cello एक ऐसा instrument है where it's beautiful, and I have heard two or three musicians who are quite a big maestros. They are a cello vadak and beautiful they play. So I would like to take the name Saskia Rao. She is a lady and she plays it beautifully, and she has her own gharana. Aur chuki cello itna zyada common nahi hai, so she is very popular also. So she brings out the ragas very well. She's an Indian classical cello accompanist. So I think it depends upon the person also, and it depends upon how you have learned it also. For example, in guitar and in other Western instruments, it may not come. Isiliye, suppose there are two types of violin, Western violin, Indian violin. Why they have made such? Because in Indian violin, they had to create that Indian raganess. Raganess means that Indian voice technicalities, the Indian raga technicalities has to come out. That's why there is an Indian violin as well. In guitar also, in Hawaiian guitar, I have heard so many, such a way the beautifully rag has been rendered by the maestros. So it all depends upon how you have got the training also, because they are able to, now I listen to so many instruments, such a good, the harkat, the murkis, the nuances come out. It's beautiful. So it all depends upon the taleem and how much time you have given to that instrument since 20 years, 25 years. For example, there is a maestro called Niladri Ji, and he has made a very good combination of sitar and guitar, and he has created an instrument called zitar. And he plays all the ragas on it, and it's beautiful and it's very, very popular. If you put zitar, Niladri, it's very, very, he has made it popular. And because of that, he has made Indian classical music also very popular. Whenever his live program comes, he plays, in the end, he plays his zitar. And it brings all the nuances inside it, because that way he has framed it. So this way we see that that everyone, it depends upon the taleem you get. And sometimes it depends, like people create, improvise the instrument, or the big maestros improvise the instrument like this. Like they form it according to the Indian nuances this way. So this is how it gets.
Okay, well, we are discussing about Rag Yaman, and we'd like to know what are the effects of Rag Yaman, and is it good for children and for elders to learn it and sing songs in that. I think it's an easy rag, the way the songs you have presented. So I think everybody can learn, but I would like to hear from you.
So should I explain the rag, or should I explain the songs or something?
I would like you to explain the rag, so that our viewers can understand the nuances of the rag and how it is sung and how it is beneficial for them.
Sure. So this is a very easy rag, and if you know that what are Shuddhaswaras, the natural notes, and it comes into very natural position of notes, except like I said, ma tivra is the ma is the higher one, ma is on the higher frequencies. So ni re ga ma dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. So like you said, it is made of seven notes. Nothing is like, varjit in it. Nothing is missed in it. So it is like, so every time it goes, ni, ni, re, ga. And the second very important note is, pa, re, ga. So, pa, re, ga and pa, re, sa is a very, very popular and important phrase in it. Ni, re, ga, pa, re, ga, no, pa, re, ga. No, ranjish hi sahi. Ranjish hi sahi. Dil hi dukhane ke लिए रंजिश ही बन सा गम अरे ये शाम कुछ अजीब थी. So like this, I can just keep on telling the ragas. And when we come to the classicality, so these few things have to be kept in mind, that nirega phrase is important, parega is important, like I gave the example, paresa is important, and ga and ni. Like you might have just got it, like gandhar ga note is very very important in this. It's called raja, the vadi in this rag. And the second most important note is ni. I can give you the example, like we halt on the ga every time.
Chandan sa badan papa magare sa. सानी रे 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 गा रे सा रे गा रे गा सानी रे धीरे से तेरा ये मुस्काना. सो वी ऑल्टेड ऑन द गा आफ्टर द फुल लाइन. मुझे दो गा गामा पदा धनी मुझे दोष न देना जग वालों.
So ga and ni are the most important notes, and this is the characteristic of the rag, that this rag is a evening rag. It is sung or played during 6 to 9 p.m. to have more of its therapeutic value, to have more of its effect on the body, on the mind, on the soul. So basically all the ragas, it's a big logic behind why you should listen to the ragas on their specific timings according to the time zones. So this rag is sung or played during the evening. And like I said, it's a very flexible raga. And there is a, so you can, instead of singing it into classical, you can sing like different classical songs in this. Classical songs like da din din da da
jao re jogi tum jao re jiya le gayo ji mora savari.
Now this is obviously it's a film music, so they have taken the shuddhama in it. It has a little mixture because nobody is questioning you in the you have all the liberties when you are creating the film song, so it's okay. But the bass is Yaman.
Jiya le gayo ji mora savariya lagi man me agan bhai bavariya jiya.
So this way, then if we come to bhajan,
Shri Ram Chandra Kru Shri Ram Nirega
came up again.
Shri Ramachandra Krupala Bhajamana Haran Bhava Bhaya Darunam.
This is also, it's a very very common popular Shri Ram Aarti. So it's a very popular rag, and people just can understand by just singing Nirega.
Nirega Madhani Zani Dapa Magarisa.
This is the ascend and the descent. Once you sing this 10 times, you will get to, you know, you will memorize all the songs and many things come up to your mind.
So, Dr. Shambhavi Das, it was so wonderful to talk to you, to listen to the songs and to understand Rag Yaman. We'll be meeting again next week and understand a different rag. Till then, bye-bye, take care.
Bye, thank you so much for having me here. Thank you.
It's all pleasure. Bye.
We have some unique Akul Mek memorabilia which will make you look outstanding. The graphics on these corporate gifts are based on the global best business practices. To become recipient of one of these gifts for free, you have to watch this video till the end and provide your valuable comments. or you can also share your experiences. The person who makes the best comment would be chosen to become a recipient of this beautiful AkulMak gift, absolutely free, delivered to your doorsteps. The winner would also get a chance to be invited live as a distinguished panelist during our next video. What are you waiting for, friends? Please subscribe AkulMak and smash that like button.